And we are back. You're still watching ANC's continuing coverage of the 2022 national elections. The second to the last day of the Filipino overseas voting in the U.S. has just wrapped up. For his assessment on the month-long voting process, we're now joined live by the Philippine ambassador to the U.S., Jose Manuel Romualdez. Ambassador, good morning from Manila. Thanks for joining us today.
Good morning to you, Carmina. Thank you for inviting.
So, what's your assessment? Second to the last day, how did it go there for the overseas absentee voting, Ambassador?
Well, as far as Washington is concerned, we've been able to send out all the ballots that we were supposed to send out. We have a total of 37,657 registered voters for Washington, D.C. For the others in New York and for the other areas, we have a total, as you know, of 212,565 registered voters in the entire United States, including the Caribbean. So we are assuming that most of them have been sent out. There have been a few hicks here and there, but that's generally, I think we've been able to send out all the ballots.
Of course, beyond the ballot, we've got to talk about the wants and the needs of the Filipino community there, which you represent. As you assess the whole voting process and as you also feel the pulse of our community there, what are their wants and their needs in the next administration, Ambassador?
Well, I think most of the voters in the United States are simply concerned about what the future is like, of course, for the country, and they want to be able to see the country continue to move forward. And of course, the relationship with the United States is important to them, being most of them are Philo-Americans already. So that generally is what they want to see.
And we talk about the Philippine-U.S. relations. Before we get into that, how is the United States viewing the elections here in the Philippines?
Well, like most elections around the world, the United States has always had some interest, especially in the Philippines, of course, because we are we're the oldest ally. As a matter of fact, President Duterte was invited to come to Washington, D.C. this week. And unfortunately, because of the elections, he will not be able to make it. In fact, the White House called me the other day asking why President Duterte can't make it. And I just simply told him that the president really was very concerned, wanted to make sure this the elections this year is going to be the best ever the Philippines ever had. And he wants to make sure it's clean and orderly and that everything turns out well.
You know, when President Duterte first started his term, many lauded him for his adherence to the constitutional provision that the foreign policy of the Philippines should be independent, until it turned out to be more and more of a pivot to China. What is at stake here for the Philippine-U.S. elections as they really take interest in the elections here in the country?
Well, I don't think it's fair to say that the Philippines is turning really completely to China. We opened our doors to China because we feel that it's an important country. And I think the independent foreign policy that President Duterte has been espousing all these years is essentially just to point out that we cannot depend entirely on the Philippines, or rather the United States alone. That is for, especially on the economic ties. Now, as far as our alliance is concerned, as we all know, the visiting forces agreement has been renewed. And I see that the mutual defense treaty is also in place, and it's even stronger than it ever was. And I think that the main message that President Duterte was able to bring out here in the United States, especially to the U.S. government, as espoused by, or by, as articulated by Secretary Austin when he went there, that we cannot take our allies for granted. And vice versa. We cannot take the United States for granted. It has to be mutually beneficial for both of us, and that it will be kind of alliance that is good for both our countries.
And this alliance, in the next 6 years, what must the next administration do to strengthen this alliance?
Well, I think that all the major candidates whom I know personally have the same kind of thinking. They all recognize the importance of our alliance with the United States, and I don't see them changing that course. And they also, most of them, if not all of them, are also in the with the belief that our relationship with other countries, the ASEAN region, is very important for us moving forward. So I see that will probably be what will happen in the future.
All right, and we're going to have to leave it at that. Philippine Ambassador to the U.S., Jose Manuel Babes Romualdez, we appreciate you joining us very early this morning here in Manila. Thanks again. Take care and you keep safe.
You too. Thank you, Carmina.